Welcome to Stern Effects. My name is Eran Stern and it is After Effects time again. In this tutorial, I'll show you everything you need to know about the Draft 3D preview mode. Now this is part 4 in a series called Speed Up After Effects. In the previous videos, I showed you how you can modify the preview settings and layer quality to help you make After Effects more responsive. But there's one more thing you can try, especially if you are working with complex 3D compositions, and this is the Draft 3D Fast Preview option, which can utilize your GPU for real-time playback. So to give you an idea why Draft 3D is so important and how it can speed up your creative workflow, I'll use this comp that I created as a fictional stinger or opener for a TV show. It consists of 26 layers in total. Most of them are extruded shape layers, but there's also some live text and pre-comps, as well as an HDR image that I'm using as an environment layer, and also a few lights and a camera, which is of course animated. Now, if this wasn't enough for you, everything here, as you can see, is very reflective. And just to make it really complex, I've added a 2D adjustment layer above everything with the glow effect. This means that each frame takes around 2 seconds or so to render. So as I showed you previously, I can try to change the layer's quality by selecting all of the layers here, and then go to the layer menu and change the quality to draft. Which doesn't seem to work here. So let's go back to the same menu and try wireframe. This also doesn't work. And the reason for that is that this comp is using the Cinema 4D renderer that doesn't support these things. So instead, we can try changing the viewer quality resolution to half, or maybe even quarter, to get faster response from After Effects, which certainly helps. But we are losing a lot of details and can't really work in real time. Instead, we can try the Draft 3D mode. Now, Draft 3D will downsample the composition and will disable some of the lights, shadows, and depth of field blur for cameras, which is irrelevant here due to the fact that the Cinema 4D renderer doesn't support these anyway. So it won't show us the exact same image, but it will allow us to preview everything in real time. And of course, you can monitor it here in the info panel, so you can see that it is playing from RAM. However, this is not accurate. I'm going to stop the preview, go back to the beginning, and I'm going to clear the cache. You can do it in a few ways. One of them is go to the edit menu, and over here you can use purge all memory, or you can use the keyboard shortcut. So I'm going to play again and notice that the green bar is not showing up. So this means that After Effects is caching those frames in another place, which is the GPU. And to illustrate this, I'm going to go to the fast preview options here, click and hold, and then choose to edit the fast previews preferences. This is going to give me some information about the GPU that I have in this machine. I can click on it and I can see that for Draft 3D, which is available in my case, After Effects is going to allocate this amount of memory. Now, depending on your configuration, I'm working with an Apple M1 Ultra on this Mac Studio machine. I can even raise this to a higher number if I need more GPU memory. And my recommendation is to use at least half of the total memory. So in my case, I'm going to type in 24 and then times, so Shift 8, 1024, which is just going to do the math for me and use exactly 24 gigabytes of RAM. I'm going to say OK over here, as well as OK for the main preferences window. And now, if I'm going to scrub the timeline here, you can see that I'm getting real-time performance. Not only that, I can also, when I'm working with Draft 3D, enable the ground plane and see how my scene is looking in relation to the infinite floor. You can also take advantage of the extended viewer, and if I'll click it, After Effects is going to render all the objects which are outside of the comp viewer. I'll zoom out by pressing the comma key, just so you can see I have a big floor over here and a lot of cubes, and most of them are going to show up in the reflection, which we can't see over here, but this is a great mode to plan our work and also check that the timing is correct. If I'll click and hold on the extended viewer options, I can adjust the opacity and make everything outside dimmer or maybe less opaque depending on my needs. So this is a great tool which you will find only when you are using the Draft 3D Fast Preview option. Okay, in this case, I'm just going to turn it off as well as switch off the ground plane and also zoom back by pressing the period key. Now, there are a few more things that can help you speed up the interaction with After Effects. For example, if you want to temporarily toggle live update mode, you can hold Alt on Windows, Option on the Mac side, while you are dragging, and this means that After Effects is not going to update the viewer. You can see the wireframe display is updating, but while I'm holding the Alt or Option, After Effects is not going to refresh the viewer. When I let go of the mouse, it's going to render it. And this, of course, works on all modes, not only in the Draft 3D mode. Another thing that you can do to prevent After Effects from updating images, and this is also true for the footage viewer, layer viewer, and of course the composition panel, is to press the caps lock key. Now, if you're going to make a change that would otherwise appear in those panels, After Effects is going to show you a red bar at the bottom of the screen with a text reminder that image refresh is disabled. To resume panel updates and display all changes, just press again the caps lock. Also worth mentioning that if you're using the Draft 3D, After Effects won't show the image on external monitors which are using the Mercury playback option. So if you're using video cards from Blackmagic Design or Aja, then you won't see the image refresh until you disable the Draft 3D preview. In any case, after showing you all of those options, I think we deserve to watch this short comp in its full glory. So I'll make sure that Draft 3D isn't enabled. I'll go to the beginning, and I'm also going to turn on the glow layer over here, and then maximize this comp panel, fit it to the frame, and preview this comp for you. For what it's worth, of course, I'm editing out the render time, but if you are curious, it took almost 10 minutes to render this composition on my Mac Studio machine. So this is it for this tutorial. I hope it was interesting to you the same way as it was for me. And if so, please like this video and also subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again in the next one.